హలో ఫ్రెండ్స్, హలో ఫ్రెండ్స్, వీ వర్ డూయింగ్ దిస్ ఎస్టిమేషన్ ఇన్ ఫోర్జింగ్ అండ్ ఫౌండరీ షాప్. ఐ హ్యావ్ డన్ టూ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఆన్ ఫోర్జింగ్ షాప్. ఐ థింక్ వీ హ్యావ్ డన్ టూ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ ఇన్ ది ప్రీవియస్ వీడియో. ఐ వుడ్ లైక్ టు టేక్ అప్ వన్ మోర్ ప్రాబ్లమ్. దీస్ ప్రాబ్లమ్స్ కెన్ కమ్ ఈవన్ ఇన్ మెటీరియల్ కాస్ట్. దట్ ఈస్ ప్రాబ్లమ్ నంబర్ 8. It says it is required to make a key of dimensions given in the figure from a rod of 20 mm dia. Determine the length of rod required for forging the key. Now the figure is like this. Figure is like this. This is the figure. This is the given figure. Here, this is this is 20 mm. This is 15. From here to here it is 75 mm. From here it is 60 mm. This is 10 mm. This way also it is 10. Here also it is 10. 10. Here it is 10. 10. This will be automatically 10. This is 8. This is 8 mm. 8 mm. Here it is 10 mm. Here it is 10 mm. He himself has divided it into three parts. He calls this as A, this as B, this as C. There are three parts. Now the total volume will be equal to VA plus VB plus VC. Now VA will be, this is a trapezoidal prism. This is a trapezium. This side it is 10, this side it is 8, and this is 60. So H by 2 into A plus B multiplied by length. H is 60 by 2, or I will take it this way. We will take it in centimeters. Afterwards, we have to divide it by this thing. So, 6 centimeters it is. All are in mm. So, 6 centimeters, this length. H, I call that, into A plus B. This is A, this is B. This is a trapezium. So H by 2 into A plus B is the formula, 1 plus 0.8 multiplied by length this way, that is 1 centimeter. So 1.8 into 6 divided by 2, so many cc. 1.8 into 1 is same one into 3, that will be 5.4 cc. Volume of B is, this part is B, this part is B, that will be area into this thing, depth. So 15 into, this will be again 15, this way it is 10. So L into B into H, that is 15 into 15 into 10, or sorry, 1.5 into 1.5. 1.5 into 1.5 into 1. 1.5 into 1.5 into 1 centimeters. So that works out to 2.25 cc. Then volume of C, again the same formula, this is a trapezium. So this is the height. Here it is 15, here it is 10. So this will be 5, this will be 5. So 0.5 in centimeters, 0.5 divided by 2 into A plus B. One side it is 1.5, another side it is 1 into length, that is also 1. So 2.5 into 0.5 divided by 2, that works out to 0.625 cc. So total volume will be, VF will be equal to VA plus VB plus VC, that is 5.4 plus 2.25 plus 0.625, that works out to 5.4 plus 2.225 plus 0.625 will give me 8.25 cc, 8.25 cubic centimeters. Now this is the volume. He has asked, what has he asked? Determine the length of the rod. So he wants length of the rod, that is length of raw material. So that will be, here no losses here. So VR is, he hasn't given any losses, is same as VF. So VR divided by AR. So VR is same as VF, 8.25. Now the rod is circular of 20 mm dia. So pi d square dr square divided by 4. Diameter of the rod is 8.25 into 4 divided by pi into 2 centimeters. Diameter of the rod 20 mm, he says. So square, that will give you the length. 8.25 into 4 divided by pi divided by again 4. That will give me a length of 2.62 centimeters or 26.2 millimeters. 2.62 centimeters. Right, this is how we have to do it. Next, coming to the foundry shop, there are no problems available here. I will just cover theory there. Now they can ask, the cost of, in foundry, they can ask foundry shop. Normally they will ask cost of pattern, cost of pattern, or cost of casting, casting. Now here, pattern, you know, you have studied foundry, you have also done foundry workshop. So cost of pattern means to produce a casting, first we must make a pattern. Pattern is a model of the casting that is required. It will be of same shape, but it will not be of same size. Why? We give some allowances here, like we give allowances like machining allowance in foundry. You get some allowances, machining allowances. That is, the casting, once it is done, it cannot be directly assembled, this thing. We have to machine it. The surface will be rough, so it has to be smoothened, and we have to give some machining allowance, then shrinkage allowance. The material is going to shrink. That is, when you pour it into the mold, it will take the size of the mold, but as the it gets cooled, it is in molten state, as it cools and solidifies, it shrinks. Then draft allowance, that is to take it out easily from the mold, you have to give an allowance called draft allowance. So after giving these allowances, now they will give you the casting size. Now what you have to do is, you have to give these allowances and prepare the pattern for that size. After giving all these allowances, patterns are generally made of wood or some light materials like aluminium, plastic nowadays, even by using this plaster of Paris, etc., are the materials that are commonly used. Now after giving all these allowances over the casting size, you have to find out the size of the pattern. Then after finding the size of the pattern, its volume is to be found out, and if they have given the density, you have to find the weight of that pattern material, and after that they would have given the rate of the material, so multiplying by that you will get the cost of the pattern. If they ask cost of the casting, that is making cost of a casting, then the material cost, the cost of the metal that is required to be poured into that, the cost of that, then the cost of preparing molds, cost of pattern, cost of preparing molds, cost of melting charges, pouring charges, that's all labor you will have to give, and overheads if any. So all these costs must be found out, and the total of all these together, cost of the metal that is by weight, that depends upon the shape and size of the casting. Again, we have to find it out as we do in the case of material cost. That is, we have to find the volume of the casting, and it's after finding the volume, its weight is to be found out by multiplying by density and dividing it by 1000. Then you have to add to that all these charges, melting charges, pouring charges, mold preparing charges, and then this thing, all those charges are to be added, and overheads if any are given, those are to be added, and finally the total cost of the casting is to be prepared. So this is the procedure to be followed, and the numerical part of this subject, estimation and costing, finishes with this chapter. So I have tried to solve almost all the problems that the different types of problems that are asked here. Now still, if you have any doubts in your mind, any problem other than what I have done, if you try to do other problems, if you get any doubt in that, you can always call me, and this thing, you please subscribe to my channel, share these videos, and use them to the maximum possible extent in your examination. I hope this will be very useful to you. I have tried to do it as best as I could. Still, if you have got any difficulties, you can call me back. If you have any suggestions, you can tell me. All this can be done. Thank you so much.